Okay, my next guest is responsible for some of the most recognisable songs of the 80s and 90s.
What a good place to be. Don't believe I speak a different language and it's never really happened to me.
This could be Rotterdam or anywhere, Liverpool or Rome.
Well, Paul Heaton has a new album out celebrating 30 years of music. He joins me now. Hurrah! I thought I wasn't going to get a chance to talk to you. I was worried then. Will you hurry up? How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Great to see you. Now, this is called The Last King of Pop. Because you don't consider yourself to be a pop star, I guess?
No, not really. I don't, but I thought I'd go the whole hog with the Last King stuff. Because I've had a sort of life of modesty, really, you know, with the House Martins, we used to call ourselves the fourth best band in Hull. And but with this, I thought, well, you know.
Go for it. Tunes are amazing. Actually, I mean, I'd almost forgotten the amount that you've done and the amazing, amazing songs that you've done. They're remarkable. Are you enjoying touring as well now?
Yeah, it's brilliant. I mean, obviously, I've been doing it for 33, 34 years. Wow. But at the moment, being a bit old and playing some of the, you know, arenas and stuff we're playing, you can really appreciate it because it feels like the sort of third time I've done it. Yeah. And being older and sort of sober and stuff like that, yeah. I think it's just a really nice time in my life.
There was a documentary about you on Channel 4 last night, in fact.
That's
and it. They were quite surprised at how modestly you live. You know the way that pop stars portrayed them, houses and swimming pools and massive cars and all of that. But you've always kind of lived under the radar a bit.
Yeah, I live in a pretty ordinary house in an ordinary area. And, I think my songwriting would actually struggle if I lived in a big house with a swimming pool because I tend to write about people people who are passing the street and stuff like that. So it might become a bit of a problem if I moved my way.
I get that. Probably you would be discomfortable as well, maybe.
Exactly,
you
know,
because it's true. It's those brilliant songs like I Love You From the Bottom of My Pencil Case.
Yeah.
That's one of the best lines I've ever
heard. It's a weird one, that, because I didn't think of it as being so eccentric, because I thought every songwriter wrote with a pencil case, and it was only when we released it, people were like, what?
But I get that. I get that. And it made me think of school as well. You know, when you have school romances and things like that. And I love the fact that when you were writing, sometimes you were writing with other people in mind, like Perfect Ten.
Yeah,
Tom Jones.
Perfect Ten.
I get that.
Yeah.
That would work really well.
Yeah, he would take it. Well, at the time, he would have taken it as sort of a dirtier song.
Yes.
And Old Red Eyes I originally wrote with Chris Rea in mind.
That makes sense.
You know, because he had that gravelly voice to go
with it.
So I sort of put these songs to other people and then I snatched them back and want to sing them myself.
But they've lasted the test of time. They really have. I mean, not all songs do.
No, I think one of the reasons for that maybe is we never used synthesizers or things that could place it now.
I get you.
It was just straightforward songs.
Yeah.
And so they've lasted because they just still sound like vocal songs, you know. I think that's the idea.
And it is a soundtrack to an awful lot of people's lives, including my own. You know, because when you hear that song, it transports you back to that time.
Yeah.
But at the same time, if I was to go and see you now, it would be very relevant. So that's
good.
Yeah, no, definitely. Yeah. Now, what's all this about Adele owing you a couple of quid?
Well, Adele actually, she was honest enough to admit that she got into one of our shows free and admitted it live on radio.
Right.
I'm just wondering what the reaction would be if I tried to persuade her security that she owed me a ticket for one of her concerts. I'm sure it could be arranged.
It might take quite a while,
but yeah.
But that was her first concert. She was a tiny little kid.
I felt really proud when she said that.
You know, I bet.
That she liked us so early, and I think her mum had smuggled her in under a coat or got her past the bouncers somehow or whatever. But yeah.
So even at an early age, I think you should take some of the credit for Adele.
She was absorbing all of you. Yeah, maybe a point on one of her records or something.
Would there be a reunion of the House Martins? Do you think that would ever happen?
No, there wouldn't.
You'd kind of done that.
Yeah, not for any reason, you know, because we all really get on well. You know, I've got a lot of time for all of them, and we have a really good friendship. Mm. But I don't like the idea of going back to another band. I don't know why. It just doesn't seem right. And I think it's a little bit like asking somebody, "Oh, are you going to go back with that girlfriend that you used to see.
Yeah, that's and a really good point, actually.
Well, yes, it might be fun for a while, but then you're back to where you were. Is it a little bit like that, you know?
I get that completely. I really do. It's so good to talk to you, Paul. I'm sorry about all the delay.
No, it's all right. You handled it very calmly.
We were sitting here watching. You should actually have had a camera on us and sound as well. It was fascinating. Yeah. Paul Heaton, The Last King of Pop is out right now, and it's so, so good to see you. And I'm keeping this.
All right. Thank you, Lorraine.
I'll be listening to it in the car. Thank you so much. Thank you. Great to see you. Now,